Hey you and welcome to my channel. My name is Tina and my aim is to improve your drawings just like others have done for me when I just started out. I'm back with another video in my small series on motivation. In my previous video, I looked at motivation through the lens of Wu Wei, which is a concept of Taoism. In a nutshell, Wu Wei stands for effortless action, and I tried to use this principle as a means to help me and you get motivated. So if this sounds interesting for you, don't forget to check that video out. However, in today's video, I will not be using ancient philosophical and spiritual traditions, but I try to compile a list with tips and techniques to help the artist get motivated. A lot of these will come as no surprise, but sometimes we all need a little help reminding us of things we already know but don't apply anymore. I'm giving you 11 that could help increase your motivation, because whether you know it or not, finding motivation is part of an artist's job. There have been countless times where I felt like picking up a brush or a pencil, but ended up doing nothing. I'm pretty sure you know what I'm talking about. Now, depending on where you are in your art journey and what your goals are, you could lack motivation for different reasons and outcomes. For example, an artist who wants to grow its following online could be growing tired of having to post so often. An artist who sells prints could be tired of the routine. Another artist could be fed up with having to draw the same thing over and over again for work, and so on. Even though these are all valid reasons why your motivation could drop, these are not the one I'm focusing on in this video. For me, these fall on the business or professional side of being an artist, and that deserves an entire video on its own. In this video, however, I want to focus on the kind of motivation that is tied to your creativity. Before I delve into the tips, hit that subscribe button right now, and this way you will push my motivation levels to new heights. Now let's dive into the tips that might give you that little push. Number one, just get started. It doesn't really matter what you end up doing, just as long as you start. Most of the time, as soon as you start, you'll remember why you love it so much, and you'll be well on your way to create your next masterpiece. Number two, and by far the biggest one, to also improve your productivity, you just need to show up. The difference between showing up and getting started lies in what you do. By showing up, I mean you can do anything as long as it's art related. Whether that is watching YouTube videos, preparing a panel, organizing your supplies, going through your older drawings, etc. If you show up each time you say you would, in the end you'll make it a habit. And once something becomes a habit, you won't need as much motivation to get going. Number three. Connect with other people. I'm not talking about your daily posts on social media where you have people liking that post or leaving a comment. You want to find people that can help you when you feel stuck on a certain piece or when you are trying a new medium and you don't know what you're doing. There are many support groups you can find online, and maybe if you're lucky, you can find some people with whom you can connect in real life. I have one older artist friend I met by chance at a gallery. Now I'm very calculated with my art, and this friend in particular helps letting me go and trying new things. And by doing so and seeing the results I've created, I actually become more motivated to start on the next one. Number four, lower your expectations. This one might sound a little bit counterproductive, but hear me out. Not everything you create will be amazing. That's just the way it is. But every piece you create will bring you one step closer to creating something beautiful. Now, if you expect each piece to be amazing, you are setting yourself up for failure. You will end up being unhappy about the result, and if this happens too often, you will become unmotivated to even create trying. All you need to do to avoid this is lower your expectations. Now, to be fair, this is something I'm still practicing. Number five, set goals. Even if you do not wish to become a professional artist, setting goals will still help you with your motivation. By reaching a certain goal, your brain receives a spike in dopamine. This is the reason, for example, why people benefit from to-do lists. The satisfaction of ticking off a small task is linked with a flood of dopamine. For this reason, it's also a good idea to break up your goals in three categories. I'm talking about long-term, middle-term, and short-term. By using goals, you can accomplish two things. The first one, like I mentioned, is that you will be happy when you've reached a goal. And the second reason is that you can direct your journey as an artist. So this is a win-win. Number six, take a class or follow a workshop. There's nothing quite like being around like-minded people. I know because I've had the pleasure of attending a workshop by Patricia Otero. Not only did this workshop get me very excited about pastel, I've never been around so many people that are also so passionate about this medium as I am. You cannot help but feel very motivated being in this atmosphere. Number 7, give yourself permission. This doesn't apply to the full-time artist who already makes art as a day job, but this one is for the people who don't seem to find the time. You have to go to work, you need to do the dishes, clean the house, make a meal, do the shopping, spend time with your family, and so on. If you let it, life can get in the way of everything, so make sure it doesn't do so with creating. Schedule time where you want to work on your art and then give yourself permission to do just that. Even if it's just 1 hour a week, reserve this time for you and stick to it. Number 8, look at art you love. It's not hard to be inspired when you are looking at art that you love. If you are anything like me, this will also inspire you to create, because after all, it's hard to see all this art that amazes you and not want to get up immediately and try it yourself. Number 9. Even if you're just an amateur artist, you must be interested in growing, otherwise you wouldn't be watching this video. So accountability is another way to help keep you motivated. If you announce to everyone that a certain piece is going to be ready by a certain date, trust me, you will do your best and more to make sure you reach this goal. It's rather embarrassing to fall behind, so it will motivate you to do what you said. Number 10, track your progress. Sometimes it can feel as though you haven't improved, which most likely isn't the case. Now, if you kept your old art, you can look at the difference between then and now. You will end up feeling good about your art and you see your progress, which in return will motivate you to keep going. Now, don't compare today to yesterday. This isn't how it works. Number 11, don't compare yourself to other people. Just as with anything in life, avoid comparing yourself with other people. This will only end up frustrating yourself, since you most likely won't be at their level. And even if you are at their level, humans always seem to find a way to bring themselves down. Now, frustration about your skill set will only diminish your motivation, so try avoid doing this. And that is it for my tips on motivation. I truly hope that if you are struggling with your motivation levels, some of these tips can help you. If you have any recommendations yourself, put them down in the comments below. I would love to read your take on this. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And I also have a lot of other videos on my channel that might interest you. So definitely check them out. Next Friday, I'll be back with another video. See you then. And in the meantime, I hope you have a great week.